Welcome to djradio.ca with iHeartRadio. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on Vibes For You, playing hip music and hosting inspirational guests and so much more. If you would like to follow me on social media, you can find me on Instagram at Chloe M Music, and I'm on TikTok, Facebook, SoundCloud, and here on YouTube at Chloe Morgan Music. Also, make sure to hit the subscribe button right now here on YouTube so you can be the first to be notified when these videos drop. Okay, so last week on the show, I featured my Taking Me There team, including Tyler McCrary, the record producer, Melina Rooney's the music video director, and Courtney Napper, the dance choreographer for the music video, which is coming up real soon, guys. We all shared our visions and thoughts about contribution through art and to make this world a better place, and the meaning and message behind the song and why people need more of this music. And of course, we featured our laughing Lovebugs, who bring our smile to our faces every show, and they're going to be on the show today, of course. So my Taking Me There music video is dropping at the end of this month, beginning of next. And I honestly can't wait for you guys to see this. It's just such a beautiful piece of art, I want to say. And, you know, it's just set to just inspire and elevate, really bringing light to the darkness, which this world really needs right now. So I cannot wait for you to see that. Also, I know a lot of you have been hitting me up lately saying, Chloe, your website's not working. I know, I'm very, very aware. We're actually having a brand new website made right now. So if you guys have been trying to sign up and you cannot, the website's going to be hopefully in the next week or so. And it's just, I can't wait for you to see it. It's going to be super slick and just like a notch up to where it was before. So yeah, go check that out. It's chloemorganmusic.com. Okay, so this week on the show, we're taking a trip down memory lane and we're bringing back a band from the early 2000s. But before we get there, if you've been tuning into my shows, you know what's coming. And for anyone new, welcome. It's so good to have you here. I play the best of the best music here on Vibes For You, and this show today is about to be fire. So let's get to it. And speaking of the 2000s, here's some Rihanna with Don't Stop the Music to get you in the mood.
Please don't stop the music, music, music.
You're listening to Vibes For You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So welcome back. I'm excited for my guests for today who actually come part of a girl group. But before we get to meet them, let me tell you a little bit about them first. The 411, who are Tanya, Tisha, Carolyn, and Suzie, are a four-piece British R&B pop girl group. The band formed in 2003 and was signed to Sony Epic by the A&R team behind the launch of Sam Smith, 5 Seconds of Summer, and Lamar. The 411 released a studio album, Between the Sheets, and 3 singles. Their debut single, On My Knees, featuring Wu-Tang Clan's Ghostface Killah, entered the UK charts at number 3, followed by Dumb, charting at number 2, and remained in the top 5 globally for weeks following the release. The 411 sat at the top of the charts across Europe and Asia and toured with many mainstream acts, including the Black Eyed Peas, Brandy, Beverly Knight, Lamar, and Take That. After the 3rd single, Teardrops, an album, Between the Sheets, was released, the 411 and Sony Epic decided to part ways, and soon after, the girls shifted their focus to their own projects. Tanya Boniface moved to America with her husband, who is a 2-time Grammy Award-winning singer-songwriter. She is an actress, a beauty business manager, and a mother to their son, Kit. Tisha Martin became a songwriter and solo artist. She recently released 2 singles from her debut EP Layers, which is dropping on May 5th of this year. 4 of the tracks were inspired by the passing of her mother, with infectious melodies and meaningful lyrics with a reggae vibe. Suzie Furlonger is one of the UK's top backing singers and has toured with Cliff Richard, Candy Staton, and Paloma Faith, just to name a few. Performing on radio and TV in-house bands such as Factor and Live Lounge, and is currently touring with Emily Sande. She is also a mother to two children. Carolyn Owlett is an actress and TV presenter and has been a broadcast journalist for national radio. She runs a publicity and broadcast media agency representing talent from the UK and USA. Her two sons have followed in her footsteps, Cassius and Billy, who recently became the youngest person ever to win an International Emmy Award for Best Actor. After almost 18 years, the 411 are reuniting and are set to perform together at Mighty Hoopla Festival and will also be part of the 90s baby pop shows later in the year. Wow, absolutely amazing and a mouthful. Welcome, ladies, to Vibes For You. It is so great to have you here with us.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you, Chloe. It's lovely to be here.
Absolutely. And congratulations on all your success. Absolutely incredible.
Oh, thank you.
So we have two of the girls joining us today. So ladies, would you like to introduce yourselves?
So hi, we're the 411. I'm Tisha.
And I'm Carolyn.
Beautiful. And we're missing
Suzie and Tanya.
Yeah.
Okay, but maybe next time we can have them on the show another time.
Yes.
Well, first of all, I want to say just like a disclosure, Tisha and I, we actually go back a long time. I don't even know, like, how do we even meet, Tisha? I'm just trying to remember. It's been like years.
I thought you went to Sylvia's, Chloe, but obviously not. Maybe that's just through mutual friends. We probably met through a producer of ours called Max.
I knew you before then.
So you've got to remind me, because
no, it was before you were in the group. I feel like I'm just trying to feel like I feel like it was when I was going to London Studio Center.
Actually, that could have been it. And when that we were dancing, right?
Yeah, and then I got onto the TV show, and then I was in the group. Yes, and then you girls in the group, because I remember you were like, because I was like, oh my goodness, Tisha's now in this group.
Your memory is so amazing, because mine's just stuck in 411 days.
But I remember you before the 411.
Yeah.
So we've known each other long, long time.
Long time.
Well, there you go. Well, I know there's been a big reunion here, which is amazing. But before we talk about that, can you share with us, you know, your experience of just being a group when you were together back in the 2000s?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it was probably the most incredible things. It was certainly one of the most incredible things that's happened in all of our lives, I would say. I think that's fair to say. And I think the beautiful thing is now we can look back on it and just be like, wow, we were so lucky to experience everything that we did. You know, it snowballed very quickly from being signed to suddenly being on stage with lots of people that we'd been watching on TV for years, and you know, these amazing opportunities, and you know, going into the studio and it's like, oh, that's Ashanti, of course we're writing with her, you know. that kind of thing just happened really, really quickly. And at the time, you don't necessarily realize how lucky you are when you're doing it. It seems like a lot of pressure and a lot of hard work, and although it is amazing, you know, it's amazing, it's not like a normal job. It does take a few years for that to not be there anymore, for you to go, wow, that was pretty special.
Yeah.
So I think all of us look back on it now fondly. You know, that's not to say that there weren't issues over the years, and you know, it's difficult to be in a girl band. It is hard.
Oh, I know.
Tanya and I were talking about this. I flew to Atlanta a couple of weeks ago to see Tanya, and we had a conversation. We said, I don't think I've ever worked as hard in my life as when we were in the band. That was the hardest work we've ever done.
And Caro, we were so young, like me and you were like 17, 18. We were like so young. So for us, it was just like, oh, this is just amazing. This is so great. We had the stamina back then, just to let you know. We were always rehearsing, just having fun. It was amazing. Yeah.
Amazing. Well, listen, can you share us some of your favorite memories together? And just like anything that you can recall that really stands out to you.
Yeah, we've got lots of those. One that actually stands out for me is when we performed at that Roman amphitheater.
Yes.
It was amazing. That was in Italy, wasn't it?
Yeah, festival bar.
Oh my gosh, it was amazing. We performed with Sting, with Moose T, with Black Eyed Peas. And I just remember being on stage and thinking, oh my gosh, like, this is just, I can't believe we're doing this. It was just amazing.
Yeah, that's there's so amazing footage actually of that somewhere. I'm so glad we found it just recently, because there's a moment where all of us are walking out on this giant catwalk with like thousands of people screaming. It's just huge, and it's, you know, it's Italy, it's nighttime, it's just beautiful. And I look at Tish and I'm just like, a really special moment, and someone captured it, which is amazing.
You were just like looking at each other like, this is it.
Like, this is our job, dude. Look at this.
We did it.
We were loving it. I think it gave us some extra courage. I remember walking down that platform, actually, because I think it was the end where you were singing, Caro.
Yeah.
And you were singing like, I can fall down on my knees, like just before we lift each other, we all have to come together. And yeah, that was a pretty special moment.
That's amazing. Oh, that's incredible. Well, listen, can you share with us maybe your favorite, one of your favorite songs? What is one of your favorite songs that you recorded?
Well, it has to be the first single, I would say. That's like the iconic, you know, song that made us, well, you know, one of them. But yeah, that would be, I think, our collective favorite.
Well, would you like to introduce, because we're going to have a musical break right now and we want to hear your song first.
Hi, we're the 411 and this is our first single featuring Ghostface Killah, On My Knees.
I can't fall down on my knees and apologize to you, because that ain't my style.
You're listening to Vibes For You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So what's up, guys? I'm here with the 411, who are a British girl band from the early 2000s and have recently reunited. And we were just talking about some of their highlights and, you know, just some of their amazing moments of being a group together. So, ladies, everybody is wanting to know this major question, which is, why did you all decide to reunite?
Ooh,
I love it. There's like a big pause. Everyone's like,
I know.
Well,
we're still waiting.
I think now for all of us, we're all at points in our lives where we've got other things going on. We're all busy. We all have, you know, projects that have become our livelihoods, essentially. So this for us can now be fun. This is something that we all are doing because we want to do it, and it seemed like a really good time. It's almost 20 years. You know, if we don't do it now, when are we going to do it, you know?
Right.
And I think, yeah, it just seemed like a good time. We love Mighty Hoopla Festival. I know Jamie Tagg, the guy that runs it, very well. Great family friend. He's been saying to me for years, come on, get them back together, please, come and play the festival. And I was like, you know what?
Huh. Yeah,
do it.
And there was a lot of like friends who said to me, like, you know, you guys are so short-lived, you shouldn't have like been, you know, you should have been around longer, you should have had more of an opportunity. We feel that, you know, you were so ahead of your time, we didn't get enough of you. So there was always this from friends, from family. So I think, yeah, as Caro said, this is the time, definitely. And we kind of felt that way as well.
Yeah, I definitely think it was like a shock, I think, when the 411 just stopped. Because it was like, when, you know, I remember even being like, what? I couldn't believe it, because I'm like, I could see you girls like rising. And I was like, not only just that, your music was great. You know, the music, which we're going to hear more of on the show. But, you know, it's just like, how did that even happen? How did like the split even, you know... When it was, it seemed to be just going so well. You were like in the top 10 with two of your singles.
Yeah, I mean, we were unlucky in the sense that our record label were quite divided at the time. I would say that the team that worked us were really behind us, but it was a very much at that time focused on sort of indie and band music. And we were kind of not necessarily going to fall into the favour of sort of the top guy at the time. So we had to really work for everything. And unfortunately, our album came out the same week that they were doing a merger with BMG. And it was basically like, if you're not multi-platinum by that week, we have too many artists, we got to cut some. And we were in that cut. And then it was kind of the situation where it's like, well, what do we do now? Do we go it together? Do we keep trying to keep going as 411? Or do we go off and try some new projects? And at that time, I think, you know, everybody kind of felt they wanted different projects. They wanted something new at that point. I think we'd been worked very, very hard, not to say that we couldn't do it. It was just, I think everybody was so shell-shocked and so tired. Because remember, we work a record in one country, you finish it and you go straight to another country and do it all over again. So everyone's like, oh, they just had a break. It's like, no, we didn't. We never had a break. And that's not just, you know, that's not unique to us. That will be every band that you see, every girl band, every boy band. Will be touring and you will see what you see in your country, and then behind the scenes they'll be going probably the same afternoon to go and do it all over again somewhere else, and that just takes its toll. And I think we made big decisions on what we would do next in a place where we were probably all a little bit tired
and also as well, I don't think that, you know, we're given that, because I remember obviously I was in a group too. It's like it's a big first of all, it's a really big deal that you guys are reuniting. It's, you know, because I was in a group too called Clear. It was around the same time that you girls were out, you know, and and it is so true. It's like when you girls split, like you all go off and you live your different lives, you know what I mean, and you grow not necessarily in the same direction. And also like splitting too, it's like you it's not necessarily that you're given the tools, the right tools at the time, you know what I mean, to be able to survive something like that. Or even know how to sort of overcome it. It's definitely, you know, I think it's a beautiful thing that you girls are coming back together. And just speaking of that, did you have any hesitations around, you know, coming back together? And if so, why?
I would say for me personally, I was very excited. But then again, I was always the excitable one of the band. I was excited over everything. So I was just like, oh my God, yeah, definitely, definitely. And because I don't have kids at the moment, you know, in the future, definitely one day, but at the moment I don't. So, and I was an only child. So for me, my main focus was my mom. So I didn't really have that much to say, oh, I've got to think about this, I've got to think about that. So for me, I was just always like, yes, I would love to reunite. I know for the other girls, it's different because they all had other things that they were focused on as well, family and things like that, which obviously it takes a lot of time, so you have to think about these things extra hard, you know, before making that decision. So
yeah, for me there was no hesitation really this time around. I feel really comfortable in where I'm at with my life. This isn't, you know, I'm not doing this to restart 411 and have a new album or anything like that. It's because it's
what Caro? No, I'm joking.
it happens right, but I've got other stuff on the go. And I think for me, certainly first time round with 411, this, I mean, it, for all of us, actually, it was our job. It was our life. We lived and breathed 411. There was nothing else. And when that gets taken away from you,
you don't know what to do.
Really traumatic.
It's like, what is my life? Like, who am I?
You hit the ground running, you know, you're literally like, what do I do now? Do I get a job? Or like, where do I go? And I think that took a bit of recovery time really for all of us. And you know, we were so young as well, and we had success very quickly, and I think we all had to go and learn who we are a little bit more. I have no idea who I was at that time, so I think now, you know, it just felt like a really good time. Everybody felt like they're in a good place. Suzie had her second baby, so she was kind of like, yeah, I'm good to do this now. I think a year before would have been too soon, like she would have been pregnant and it would have worked. And you know, Tan's like all of us, she's like, yeah, I just want to do it, it's fun.
So, yeah
it was a good time.
Beautiful. Well, can you share with us another favorite song of yours that you girls did?
What would you say, Caro?
I would say it's got to be the song that probably most people know us for, and that is Dumb.
Yes. Well, please introduce.
So we are the 411, and this is our biggest single of all time. It is Dumb. Above the feeling,
this is real feeling. Boy, I didn't know you cared. It's the Laughing Lovebugs. And we're here to show you another laughter exercise. We're going to imagine we made a huge mistake. But instead of being hard on ourselves and getting in our heads about it, we're going to show you an exercise that's called mistake laughter. We're going to point to ourselves and laugh. Try it with us.
Ha 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 ha
You're listening to Vibes For You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So those were our laughing love bugs. And, you know, I always encourage people to just stop and do these laughing exercises just because, well, for your mental health alone. You know, I actually, you know, pulled this tool out the other day when I was talking to my mom. You know, she was having a bad day and just sort of expressing herself to me, you know, and at the end, instead of me trying to fix her and trying to, you know, problem solve, I just said, why don't we just have a good laugh, mom? And we did. We just both started cracking up and it totally shifted both of our moods because obviously, you know, like even though I love being there for my mom, it's like it can be challenging, you know, at times. And it's like, oh, let's just have a good laugh because it totally elevated everything. So yeah, I totally encourage everybody to do it. Just do it. You will not regret having a good laugh. So I'm here with the 411 and we've been talking about them reuniting as a band after nearly 18 years. By the way, girls, how did you enjoy that?
That was so fun.
That was so good. I'm thinking you need to send some videos through, Chloe, because that they'll help in stressful situations.
I should just get you girls connected with them because they would probably be amazing for you guys. Like you could just use it as a tool when you're rehearsing, just like stop everything and just be like, if anything gets stressful, girls, we're going to have a good laugh right now. And just laugh.
It will totally work.
I've tried it a few times now. Let's talk about, you know, the fact that obviously, you know, you reuniting, I really believe is a really powerful message in itself, you know, because it just speaks to restoration and unity. Why do you feel that is a really important message right now for people to see just more of these kind of messages based on unity and restoration?
I mean, I just think, you know, with everything that's going on in the world right now, we all need to come together. And, you know, if we can do it just, you know, a small group, then, you know, anybody can do it really. And I think, I don't know, I just think there's so much more power in it being just one person. And we always used to say in the band, it was, can you imagine trying to do this as a solo artist? Because it can be really grueling. And there are amazing moments, but there are moments where you feel a little bit lonely or a little bit down or, you know, just stressed generally. And we were really lucky because you'd have three other girls in the band who would be there with their energy to go, okay, we're pulling her out the hole, you know? And I think that is really beautiful and something that, you know, I think if you have that in life, how can it possibly be a bad thing?
I agree, Caro, because I'm actually pursuing a solo career right now. And sometimes I'm like, where are my girls? Sometimes I need that support, you know? So I totally get that. I also feel that there's a strong message of like strength in numbers as well. And just showing how, even though we had, you know, tiny little disputes, we can put that aside and come together for people who helped us to get where we were, you know, to show that it's all about the music. And music is a very powerful thing as well. I think it brings people together. It's universal. It's a universal, you know, love language. So the fact that we're coming together now, despite everything that's going on in the world, is, I think, is very powerful.
Absolutely. No, I think it's, I love how these whole things are about reuniting. And I think, you know, it's definitely like an expression of where I think the world, like you said, what the world needs to happen in the world. And so when you see things like this actually happening, like bands coming back together or people coming back together or marriages coming back together, you know, I really feel like that's what the messaging really does actually need to be, because no matter what you're going through in life, you can still come back together and you can still have a bond and bring back something beautiful. And also, you know, I'm sure the fans can't wait for you, and it's like you're giving them a gift because of something that obviously they've wanted to see. Now you're giving back, you know, so that's really, really beautiful. Also, you know, just to kind of like touch on that too, you know, the fact that obviously I'm sure that you've grown over the years, you know, spiritually, mentally and physically. What is the message that you want to get across to your audience now?
I think it would be very much the case that today is today, tomorrow is tomorrow. Whatever happens today, you can leave it today and make tomorrow a different day. So everything is changeable. You may be feeling really sad, down, not where you want to be, feel like you're struggling today, but tomorrow you can change that. Mm. And I think to never have limitation on yourself and to know that you can change anything that you want to change for the better. You have to do the work to do it, but everything is changeable. If something isn't working for you, you can change it. You are never stuck and unable to change things. That would be mine.
Anything you want to add to that, Tish?
So I would also say, do what you love. You know, I think a lot of people, they do things that they think that they should do or to please other people. But I really believe that if you focus on what you love, and obviously coming from a good place, but put everything in what you love, then you'll be happy. You know, obviously you'll have challenges, but if you focus on what you love, you can just, you know, grow from there, elevate from there. And I think that would be a positive way forward.
And definitely. I think as well, you can just do anything in this life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anything that you put your mind to, we're unlimited human. Mm. We're spiritual beings having a human experience, you know? So really, like, the only limitations that we're putting on is ourselves, you know what I mean? Because we can actually do anything in this life. We just have to believe that those things are possible and actually put the work forward and dedicate yourself and focus, you know, because if you want to be in a group, if you don't want to be a group, you want to get back together, whatever you want to do, all these things are possible to those that believe. Mm. You know what I mean? So I think it's just about having that limitless mindset of just like, I can do it and so can you. Anybody can do this.
There's a great saying, and you'll probably know it, most people do, it's called fake it till you make it. And I think it's genuinely true. Do, go for it. You know, believe you can do it. And then one day you'll be like, oh, I am doing it. This is it. And that definitely is what happened to us in the band, I would say. All of us have moments where we stood on stage and we're like, oh, wow, we are actually doing this. This is happening. Mm. And all of us grew up, you know, thinking, well, I want to be a pop star when I'm older. Or I want to be an actress when I'm older. And we all made it happen. And, you know, it may not be that you're doing that for the rest of your career, but you'll have moments in your lifetime. And I do believe that we live so many different lifetimes within our lifetime.
Right, absolutely.
So things will change, things will pass, but you keep growing and take those experiences and those moments and cherish them, because that's what we're doing with the band now, is looking back at it with kind of rose-tinted glasses. However many years on, going, let's enjoy the good bits and let's try and emulate some of that again now.
Yeah, and everything that we do as well, it builds more confidence to the next thing. You know what I mean? So that fake it till you make thing is actually what it is like, you've built the confidence, you gain the experience, and that is what actually transcends you and transforms you into who you are becoming. Well, listen, we want to hear one of your songs, another one of your songs. Which one should we play?
Oh, I think we should go very up-tempo and happy, and a song that makes us all just really enjoy being together and having a good old dance. And so that would be Chance.
Yes.
Amazing. Okay, well, here is the 411 with Chance.
When you see me in the club with another guy, remember it was you who said goodbye. You expected me to sit around and wait for you, telling you, boy, that you're not that fly.
The other one who told me of lies, it was obvious from the guilty look in your eyes, but really, boy, it comes as no surprise that you were playing me. Now you thought it was enough to spend your money on me, when I really want to spend time in your company. I've tried so many times to make you see that you can buy my life.
brought you joy. Most things you own don't mean to moan, but it's not okay, boy. Don't think I don't know.
To Vibes For You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So I have my ladies here from the 411, and we've been getting deep into conversation with the girls, you know, about coming back together after all these years. But we want to know more. So ladies, what do we have to look forward to this coming year with the 411? Tell us all the info we want to know.
Well, we obviously have the Mighty Hoopla Festival, which is a really big festival here in the UK. We're really excited for that because that's where we're going to be doing our reunion. So everybody is looking forward to that.
That's your first one that you're going to be doing.
Yes, that's amazing. Our first one. And that will be on the 4th of June. So, yeah, that's a big
Get
one.
Get your tickets.
We also have, is it the 90s Babies Tour?
Yeah, 90s baby pop tour.
Pop tour, that's it. Yeah.
Which is funny because we technically weren't 90s, but
no. Yes. So we're quite excited for those too. And there's some other things in the pipeline, but I'm not sure we can say just yet. What do you think, Caro?
Not just yet. More tour stuff coming up.
Yeah,
like Tisha, we've got an arena tour at the end of the year in the UK. And I know the 29th of October is at the Manchester Arena. Can't tell you where the others are, but you can find it online.
Yeah.
Well, we're all going to be looking those things up online. And when I turn this recording off, I'm going to get you to give me the 411 on that.
Yes.
Amazing. Okay, cool. Can you share a little bit about what's going on in your own lives, you know, as well? Because I know, obviously, you have your own lives too. Anything you want to share? I know Tisha's got her album coming out.
Yeah, so I have an EP coming out. It's my first EP as a solo artist. After the band, I kind of, you know, concentrated on family. My mum was very ill and then she passed away. So I took a few years out to just deal with my emotions. And, you know, it was hard for me to continue music. But somewhere through all of that I did, and I wrote a few songs, you know, after the passing of my mom, and they're on this EP. But it's funny because we're talking about love, and even though it was a very sad time in my life, all of these songs are kind of rooted in love. So the center of all of them is love, basically. And I put them all on this EP. There's four songs and they all have a reggae feel. So I'm kind of going back to my Jamaican roots as well. Yeah. But it's not full reggae. So it's reggae with a slash of maybe R&B or soul, I would say.
Amazing. Well, go and get the EP. Go and download it.
Layers.
Well, I'm actually spending a lot of this year, my sons, as you said, have gone into acting as well. And so my youngest son is currently the voice of a kids cartoon called Mia's Magic Playground. He is Oscar in that. So we have lots of recording sessions for that one.
Nice.
And my oldest son is shooting two movies at the moment. I can't say what they are, but one of them from a pretty epic, how do you say it, superhero line. And the other one, he's actually in a show called Invasion, which is on Apple TV, and he plays Casper in that. So I'm doing some bits and pieces for that too. So,
amazing. Yeah,
busy times.
So you're really focused on your boys.
I mean, I'm not. I've got my own stuff going on as well. Like you said earlier, I run a publicity agency. There's constantly things happening on the go. I finished a series for ITV. I haven't got the release date for that, so I can't actually say too much about it yet. But about 2 months ago, I finished doing something for that. And then I'm just doing sort of freelance presenter bits and pieces. So, you know, I'm constantly working, thank goodness, but very busy as well. So it's nice.
Beautiful.
I get to travel, I get to go anywhere in the world with my kids as well, which is fun. And yeah, just being me.
Beautiful, I love it. That's amazing. Okay, well, I'm actually gonna be playing a mega mix right now. And because you ladies are on the show, because the 411 are here, I'm going to be doing their favorite influences today for this mega mix, and I'm calling it the 411 mega mix. So enjoy.
You're listening to Chloe.
We're here on Vibes For You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So that was the 411 Mega Mix and their favorite influences. Ladies, I hope you enjoyed that. You liked it?
Yes, so, definitely.
Amazing. Well, it's you guys' influences. So if you didn't, there must be a problem.
That'll be strange.
Very strange.
Very eclectic mix.
Yes.
So if you would like to request any ideas for music or my mega mix, you can DM me on Instagram at Chloe M Music, or you can send me an email to info@chloemorganmusic.com. So ladies, I dedicate a section to gratitude. And I always ask my guests to share gratitude. You know, even when my daughter was under the weather the other week, I just kept saying to her, you know, I just kept being like, Amani, tell me something you're grateful for. Because she was like, nye, nye, nye. And I was just like, what are you grateful for? And we went through it. I'm grateful for my mommy. I'm grateful for my daddy. I'm grateful for God. I'm grateful for me. And I'm telling you, like, she went from like really moaning to like, all like happy, because gratitude is just something, it again is just something that shifts atmospheres and it just elevates us. So that's why we're going to do gratitude.
Definitely.
I'm totally with you on that. I actually started doing a gratitude journal this year.
Love that.
Yeah, I work with a lady called Aisha Bell. You should follow her. She's amazing.
I'm always thanking God all the time for any, like, even things that I'm believing for, I'm thanking it like it's already happened.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, and just that's gratitude, and constantly being in the flow of that is really, really powerful. So turning it over to you ladies, three things that you are grateful for.
I'm also grateful for God. God has played a big part in my life ever since I was very young. Mm-hmm. Especially when I lost my mum. Yeah. It was a very difficult time for me, and I was questioning my faith. I was questioning why me, you know, because I was very close to my mum. But through it all, God stayed with me. He gave me my husband. He gave me happiness again. He gave me a comfort that I couldn't find anywhere else. So I would say that would be my number one.
Beautiful.
And I think for me, it would be my family and my friends who have become my family. I'm very much a person that believes that your family are the people that are closest to you. You
don't, for sure.
It's your chosen family is your family. It doesn't yeah. have to be blood at all to be a family.
Yeah.
And right. I have seen my chosen family and my family step up for me in a way since I left the band, really, and throughout my entire life, but especially in the last 18 months, in a way that I could not have got through it without them in every sense. So I'm eternally grateful for them and the love that they give to my children now as well.
Beautiful. For me, as well as family, I would say health and strength, because there are so many people that, you know, are not able to get up and not able to just walk. And sometimes we take for granted the simplest little things, like being able to see, being able to hear, being able to get up and do our own things, being able to, you know, help others as well, you know. And I think that health and strength is just a big thing for me.
This is when you realize when you get sick.
Mm.
You know, like I wasn't well the other day, and it's just like, this is the worst thing, you know, when you lose your health. So it is something that we should always be grateful for, you know what I mean? Just the fact that we woke up today, that there's breath inside of our lungs.
Yes.
No, there's absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, I would obviously say the same as well. I mean, you know, definitely health. And I think strength is another thing. Strength in every sense. The strength to know yourself and the strength to know when something isn't right as well. I'm really grateful. I've got a very good gut instinct, which for a lot of people used to say, well, it's really negative. It's really negative on stuff. It's not. It's just I know if something feels good and that's the path I want to go with, that it, I feel it in my body. Yeah. I literally can feel what I should be doing in certain situations. It doesn't mean I've got them right all the time, but I've now learned to trust my instinct. So I'm grateful for that.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say the third thing would be, it's between two things, but I'm going to choose one. The third thing would be music, because for me, music has always been a part of my life since an early age as well. Just obviously being with the girls in the band, how much that has influenced who I am today and how much it has helped me through situations. There's been times when I've been down, going through emotions, and just put on a song. And then it's lifted my mood or it's helped me through a certain situation. So music, I would say definitely. Yeah, I'm grateful for that. Yeah.
Music's really, really good. I'm copying you with all of these now.
No, because I know these are similar for us.
Yeah, well, this is what happens when you have the shared experiences, isn't it?
Definitely.
But yeah, I'm very much a music person as well. I was trying to explain to somebody the other day how I felt and I literally couldn't explain it. It's like, I'm going to send you a playlist. And they're like, oh,
exactly. There you go.
Okay. All of it now. And it's the journey. And I'm also grateful for life generally, to have the life that I have, you know? It's not necessarily the life I thought I would have or where I thought I wanted to be, but it's pretty good. So,
yeah, I think it's really important to show gratitude to yourself. You know what I mean? And I think it's like when they say love your neighbor as yourself. Well, if you don't love yourself, you know, and this is, and I know it's easy to say like, oh yeah, I'm going to love myself. But actually to really love yourself, it really does take a lot of like, it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of looking in within, working out the things that need to be worked out to truly love yourself and forgive yourself and, you know, give yourself that, the grace that you need to be able to give to others. You know what I mean? I tell my daughter, I'm grateful for me, you know, because, and what we should always have a good self-image of ourselves. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, because it's so easy to just fall into like that negative cycle of just putting yourself down. And then, and it's like one negative thing can counteract five positive things. So that's is a very powerful emotion. That's why we need to always be in that vein of like speaking well about ourselves, having gratitude for ourselves and being in that flow, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And it's really, really important.
Yeah, I think that's really beautiful that you're teaching that to your daughter so young as well.
Like, yeah.
It's something that all our younger generations need to hear, is that it's okay to love yourself and to be kind to yourself, you know, because nobody will be a bigger critic of you than yourself as well.
So yeah, and the fact that we're all different too, you know, we've actually got this book, speaking of which, and it says, it's called I Love All of Me. And it goes through all the different parts of your body and says, I love my hair so free. I love my brain so wise. Like at the end, then it's like, I love all of me. And I just love it because it's teaching, you know, my daughter to be able to really just love herself. Because I think that is where we get flawed as a child. You know, like something comes in that some type of trauma or something, and then we start to not like ourselves. You know, and so if we can actually just really implement, like continuing to like teach our the next generation, our children, to really love themselves, like they're not going to have to deal with half the issues that we necessarily went through, you know, and for the season and time that we've been in as well. So
definitely, I think, you know, we spoke loosely about this before when we were off air, but it's a great thing to see where we're at now, that mental health and self-care is really promoted in the way that it is, and it's seen as important, because, you know, Chloe, you'll know yourself, back when we were in a band, it really wasn't. It was like, just work, just do your thing.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how, where your head's at, just get on with it. And I think now it would be very different to be in a band. I'm not saying it would be easier necessarily, but I think there would be more sort of palliative care and care of what is going on with the individuals that aren't necessarily just a product. They are human beings.
Mm. Well, let's hear another one of your songs. What one do you want to play now?
I'm going to play one of my favorites. Okay. Cara's looking at me like, what one's that? Let's go with Teardrops.
All right, here we go. Here's the 411 with Teardrops.
Hey, what are you doing?
Just laughing.
You're listening to Vibes for You. I'm Chloe Morgan, your DJ and host on djradio.ca. So welcome back. I'm here with the 411 and we are down to the last part of the show, where every month I get to ask my guests 5 fun questions. So it's your turn now, girls, to be in the hot seat. Are you ready?
Ready.
The pressure is on. Let's do this. So, okay, so first question. If you could change anything in this world, what would it be?
Ooh. Can I say this pandemic? Because it's just caused such a like divide between people, even though, you know, we're fighting against it and we're coming together. I feel that it's put a lot of fear into people. Yeah, even though it's something that has made us think about what's important to us, I do feel that a lot of people have been scared, and it's made us not want to come together because we're scared of catching something, or, you know, so I would say this pandemic has been quite a downer for a lot of people, mm-hmm. as well as war and, you know, the usual yeah. stuff that we'd love to change.
I mean, I'm the sort of person that believes, I suppose, that like everything is meant to be as it is, because that's why we're here. And I really believe like this whole thing actually is to transition us into a higher level of ourselves. I feel like we're actually elevating. It's like whatever the enemy meant for harm, God will use for good to those that love him. Anything that was bad can still be turned around and be used for good. Even though, yeah, it's been a lot of bad stuff for sure, I feel like there's also been a lot of good things that have kind of happened because of it, because it's almost like people have been sort of compressed into something. But then what happens when you go through the fiery furnace, you come out the other side shining like a diamond. So I believe like that's what I'm believing for in this time, is for things to shift in that way. But I can definitely understand what you're talking about there for sure. Okay, next question. If you could make a stranger's day, what would you do?
I would just stop them for a second, and I think I would tell them 5 amazing things that I see in them straight away.
As love it. Like a mirror.
Because there's something good in everybody, and often before you know the person is the best time to go, what do I see before I know anything and I'm sort of tainted by what I do know, you know? So my honest moment would be to say 5 amazing things.
Beautiful.
That's lovely, actually. I actually did this once, so I think I would do it again. So I saw a homeless person on the street. It was quite cold. No one was, you know, everyone was walking past him. People were giving him money and stuff. And I just thought, I'm going to sit with him for a little bit and just have a chat with him. And I sat with him for about 10 minutes and was just speaking to him. And he said it was really nice because no one takes the time out to actually talk to him. So for me, it would just be to give someone that extra little time.
Love that. Yeah, we all need time. You know what I mean? Like, time is one of the most valuable currencies that we have. Okay, if you could fly or be invisible, what superpower would you choose?
Oh, fly.
I would choose fly as well.
Yes, that's no brainer.
I feel like I would like to fly more than I'd like to be invisible. I've got this real personal thing about not liking to, I would never check someone's phone. I would never, you know, if I'm on the train, I'm not the person kind of looking over. I really don't like doing that. I'm very much about personal space. So being invisible wouldn't be good for me. I would just probably sit down and watch the TV and be useless. So I would definitely fly.
Yeah, me too.
And do you think you have a superpower?
I think we all have superpowers.
What is your superpower, Tish?
Okay, so I would say, I don't want to sound like I'm picking myself up, but I've been told this by others. So they always say to me, you're always so bubbly, or you're always so happy, you're always, you know, able to see the good in someone else. And I feel that, yeah, that could be a superpower.
You can totally big yourself up. This is the space to do that. Go for it.
Or I feel like, you know, I'm quite empathetic to people. So I find that I connect with them more on a personal level. And I like that.
Beautiful. Yeah, I feel you.
Do you want mine as well?
Yes, of course. Oh, okay. Tell us.
I would say my superpower is my strength to keep going at times when everybody else would probably give up. I just keep going. That's my thing.
Resilience.
I've always been like that. I get that from my family, who we have the same, my family. Nobody's coming to save you. No one's going to come. And I remember when I finished with 411, I was talking with my dad and he said to me, no one's going to knock on the door and offer you a record deal or do this or do that. You got to get up and do what you want to do next. And I was like, you know what? You're so right. That is what I have to do. I have to just keep going. And so that's the thing, to keep being resilient. And some days it's exhausting. Some days it is. Some days you just think, oh, can I really be bothered with this or whatever it is.
But look how far you've come and look what you've achieved.
I know.
So it's amazing.
I told her that the other day, by the way. I'm so proud of her. Like, she's like superwoman to me.
Totally.
So
there we have it. So if you could go back in time or into the future, what would you choose?
Oh, back in time.
Yeah, back in time.
Really?
Back in time. Yes,
for sure. 100%. I would love to relive the 411 again, knowing what I know.
With the knowledge
now.
You have now, yes.
Yes.
And you know, I was speaking to both Tanya and Suzie about this, and we all said the same, how different we would take it and how it would totally, we'd understand just to not sweat the small stuff and stand our ground more.
And enjoy it even more, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, you know what? These are lessons, you know what I mean, that you can use now and you know that you've learned. I'm the same as you too. Like, you know, I'm like, I don't even recognize the person I used to be, you know what I mean, to who I am now. And I just find like when I live my life now, I just enjoy every moment. Even like the difficult moments, I'm like, wow, like I'm really strong through this because I'm still responding in love. You know, I'm still responding in the best way I know. And I'm in a place now where I'm free and I'm just enjoying life. You know, like I'm happy. It's like, I actually was like the other day, I'm like, I'm actually happy. Like, this is what it feels like. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's, and do it's you know a- what? I genuinely think that in life, that's the greatest thing that you can get is love and happiness. If you can get those two things, you've lived a good life.
And you're doing what you love as well.
Yeah.
Very. I feel that's really important, you know?
Yeah. But I feel like I'm here right now. And this is like, even in this moment, this is where I'm meant to be. And it's a beautiful thing. I'm meant to be here with you girls right now. Okay. Yes. So the next question, which takes me into that, is if you could be anywhere in this world, where would you be?
Wow.
I would be in America. I love America, and I really want to move to America, and that is my forward-thinking plan. For some people, they go there and they're like, oh, it's not for me. But for me, I land there and I think, oh, I feel like I'm home. And I don't know why, it's just always been a thing. You know, I've got great friends that live there. Tanya lives there. and just every time I go there, I feel like it's home already. So that would be where I would be.
Mm-hmm. I'll be there with you.
I would say it would probably be at home in Jamaica on the beach, just because I'm a water baby and I love being by the sea. I love like the peace it gives me. I love watching sunsets and just being free by the ocean. So I would love to be there.
Love it. Love it. Beautiful. Thank you so much, girls. And thank you so much for being on the show today on Vibes for You. We have loved having you here. And also thank you to our listeners tuning in as well. I hope you enjoyed the show. But before you go, ladies, can you let people know where they can find and follow you?
Where can you find and follow us,
Steve? Yeah.
I'm not really a big social media person, so I'm...
Well, I know on Instagram you've got 411 UK. Is it at the 411 UK?
It is.
Yes.
That's one.
So I've got my own Instagram, Tisha Monique Music. I'm on YouTube as well with the same Tisha Monique Music and Facebook. But I'm not really a big social media person either, but... they will be the places.
There is a fan account you can follow us.
Oh, yes.
We'll be posting more on that.
Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Thank you so much. And make sure to watch the show on my YouTube channel at Chloe Morgan Music. And stay tuned for the next show, which is once a month now on the first Saturday of the month. And of course, I'll be letting you know what's coming up next on my social media at Chloe M Music on Instagram. And I'm Chloe Morgan on Vibes for You at djradio.ca and iHeartRadio station. And to close it off, we're going to hear one last song from you girls.
What should it be?
I think it should be China Girl.
I was going to say that. I was going to say it, but I'll let them say it first.
Yeah, it's going to be China Girl.
Beautiful. Well, would you like to finish off together introducing it?
Very much so. So we have been and still are 18 years later, the 411. And this is China Girl.
China Girl.
Beautiful. Enjoy. Thank you guys for tuning in. Here's the 411 with China Girl.